Hello students, we have already discussed poem number first, My Mother at 66 by Kamala Das. Today we will learn second poem, An Elementary School Classroom in a Slum by Stephen Spender. So short introduction of the poet. Stephen Spender, 1909 to 1995. Stephen Spender was an English poet and an essayist. He left University College, Oxford without taking a degree and went to Berlin in 1930. Spender took a keen interest in politics and declared himself to be a socialist and pacifist. Books by Spender include Poems of Dedication, The Age of Being, The Creative Element, The Struggle of the Modern, and an autobiography, World Within World. In An Elementary School Classroom in a Slum, he has concentrated on theme of social injustice and class inequalities. So before you read, there is one question. Have you ever visited or seen an elementary school in a slum? What does it look like? So this is the very important question. In India also, there are so many slum areas. Especially, suppose we are now in Maharashtra. So in Mumbai, Dharavi area, that is slum area. And you might have seen the documentary movie, that is Slumdog. In that also, how is the life of slum area? It is picturized. And here, author is highlighting two important things. In that is, two things are here discussed. Important thing it is social injustice and class inequalities. So, we will discuss both the themes along with the examples, whichever year Stephen Spender focused in his poem. So, stanza number first, we will start. Far, far from gusty waves, these children faces. Like rootless weeds, the hair torn round their pallor, the tall girl with weighed down head, the paper seeming boy with rash eyes, the stunted unlucky hair of twisted bones, reciting a father's gnawed disease, his lesson from his desk. At back of the dim class, one unnoted, sweet and young, his eyes live in a dream of squirrel's game in tree room other than this. So line number first, far, far from gusty waves, deep children faces. So gusty waves means strong winds. And here this gusty waves is a metaphor, and it is stark contrast with the reality of the children, that children's faces are very pale. There is no charm on their face. They are far, far from gusty waves. That energy is not there. So in the beginning itself, Stephen Spender used two poetic devices. In that, far, far, it is repetition. And far from, here alliteration also, it is mentioned. And in Gusty Bale's metaphor, where indirect comparison, it is also used. Then in the next line, like rootless weeds, the hair turn round their pallor. So now here, in second line, poet again use the simile. Poet is trying to convey the message using poetic devices. So simile here using like rootless weeds, the hair turn round their pallor. So here, the condition of the slum area children, it is like rootless weeds, unwanted plants. And how that unwanted plants are not noticed by anyone. So the children, they are also facing the same problem that no one is taking care of them. And how is their appearance? The hair turned round their pallor, means pale face. So their faces are dull, pale faces, wan. The reason is they are not getting enough food to eat, they are not getting quality education, and they are not getting the love of the society. So all the important things which is required for all human being, but they are deprived from all that things. So here in the next line, third line, the tall girl with weighed down head. So poet is now trying to highlight the situation, taking help of the representatives. And in that slum area classroom, so the title is an elementary school classroom in a slum. So in that classroom, the senior girl, means the tall girl, with her weighed down head, means that tall girl is in depression. There is a burden, and that burden may be that there is no hope in her life. There is no opportunity in her life. That classroom, in that classroom, so many children are there, but they belong to that slum area. And no one is taking care of them. And the major thing, it is poverty also. So one of the important theme it is handled here, that is poverty. And social injustice, it is there that they don't know the outside world, the normal world. They don't know how to go ahead with proper planning. There is no plan, there is no vision, and there is no opportunity. And especially I will mention, that is equal opportunity which others they are getting. And that is the social injustice and class inequalities that they are facing. So the girl is weighed down, means she is having the burden and there is no hope in her life. So she is too much nervous. And in that nervous state of mind, here poet is trying to highlight through the weighed down image. Then next, further poet is trying to explain the situation. The paper ceiling boy with rash eyes. Now the girl situation we have discussed. The paper ceiling boy. Paper ceiling is very thin, maybe because of the malnutrition. They are not getting enough food to eat. So here, the paper ceiling boy, which is very thin, and it is again compared with rash eyes. So both the words, here it is important that rash eyes, that boy is looking very thin, and the rat's eyes, particular this word is used to highlight that rats are always looking here and there, they are searching for something, and that greediness, that the rats may be hungry. So here that the hunger in both ways, that boy may be hungry, means here food, they are not getting enough food, as well as the quality education, means they are poverty stricken. So education is very important for everyone. If you are not getting that education, means you will not get the opportunities which others are getting, and you will be deprived for so many years, generation by generation. That slum area children, they are deprived. Then further, poet describes one more boy, the stunted, unlucky hair of twisted bones, reciting a father's lung disease. So one more boy, and that boy's condition is that stunted, unlucky hair of twisted bones. Means here, the condition is, the boy is also facing the problem, that facing the problem of health, and that boy is reciting a father's null disease. Means personal hygiene is not maintained. Parents, they are also not maintaining their personal hygiene. And due to poverty, they are not getting proper nutrition. And the same thing, it is inherited from father. Means that unhealthy condition. And in that unhealthy state of mind, the physically, the boy is not fit. So, here it is important that we should try to convince everyone, those who are in living their standard life, that you should go and visit the slum area and observe their condition, and you may create a group or NGO, or with a friend's help, at least you can help one family or the children, those who are now in those who are taking elementary education. Because primary education, it is the base, and if that base, if they are not getting, then they will be in problem. His lesson from his desk, and that boy is there, but he is facing the problem, is taking the lesson, is, but what is here specially author mentioned, that reciting a father's null disease, means he is inherited and he is the unlucky heir, unlucky successor of the family, and he is reciting that father's null disease, means, and this will again be there in their family, generation by generation this will happen, and one day there will be big chaos, that we may not be able to understand that why this is happening, why their health is day by day deteriorating. So this is very important thing here, where it is willing to highlight. At back of the dean class, and one more here example, one more representative here from that slum area, we discussed about that. At back of the dean class, one unnoted, sweet and young. Now here, unnoted means unnoticed. Without that boy is not noticed. And where he is sitting? At back of the dean class. And once you will go in slum area, you will understand that in our school, we are observing that ventilation is good, light, everything it is good, sunlight, everything we can enjoy. But in slum area, the classrooms are dark, and in that darkness, that boy is sitting at the back of the dean class, and he is not noticed, unnoted. And what is that boy doing? And that boy is sweet and young. So child, in that childhood age, everyone is looking very nice. They are innocent, but they are the victim of of the poverty. They are the victim of the social injustice. It is not their fault. Humanity is important. To take birth in poor family, it is not in their hand. That way to take that birth. But it is everyone's responsibility as a citizen that we are every day taking the pledge, and in that place we are mentioning that they are the brothers and sisters, but in reality very few they are going there and helping them. Or nearby means railway station also, bus stand, you will observe so many children that they are taking, means they are picking up the things from different areas, and they are behaving like rat pickers, or some they are child laborers. So whenever you will observe the condition, that condition it is also seem like a slum area children. His eyes live in a dream. But here poet is again here signifying that there is a dream in that boy's also mind, and that boy is also thinking to come out from that slum area, and he wished to explore his world. Dream of squirrel's game in tree room other than this. Other than this means other than this clumsy atmosphere, dim class, the class infrastructure is not good. There is no anything which is good for that child. So that child is not interested in the learning. It is important for everyone to get proper environment for learning. So here the boy is more interested in the outside world, and you can observe the squirrel. Squirrel is very energetic. That squirrel's movements are very energetic, and that will give you energy. Whenever you are observing that squirrel, charm, happiness. And that tree room, it is more beautiful, more comfortable than the slum area classroom. So that boy may be interested in that squirrel game rather than the learning in that slum area classroom. So here tree room is also the metaphor, because this tree room is highlighting the outside world or the nature, because everyone is willing to go out and learn so many things in the nature, because nobody likes to live in a cramped holes. Afterwards that image of cramped holes, it is used, we will discuss afterwards in stanza number 3, it is there. So in stanza number 1, some important things here poet highlighted, in that poet had taken 3 representatives. One is tall girl. That tall girl, she is facing the problem of burden, nervousness, oppressed behavior due to poverty and lack of opportunities. Then one more important thing here poet used, that the unlucky hair, and that boy is reciting the father's plant disease and twisted bones. Malnutritious children, if you will observe the image or video or just photograph, you will observe that the image, the twisted bones, and that boy may not be that much active, because if you are physically fit, then only will be sound, and that here it is lacking in that atmosphere in the classroom which poet is purposefully observing. And the third is one more boy. That boy is in the dream, and here little bit poet is hopeful that even though they are in that slum area, but they are dreaming. Understood? So you can observe, there are so many videos also you can listen, you can watch on YouTube, that in slum area some children, they work hard, and now they are the officer, so many different multinational companies, or in civil services also they are good. Means some they are also keeping their dream in that adverse situation. So here there is a hope, or that optimism we can observe. So multiple interpretations we can do for this. Then we will start the next stanza. On sour cream walls, donations, Shakespeare's head, cloudless at dawn, civilized dome riding all cities, bell flowery, Tiberius valley, open-handed map, awarding the world its world, and yet for these children, these windows, not this map, their world, where all their futures painted with the fog, a narrow street sealed in with a lead sky, far, far from rivers, kids, and stars of woods. We will discuss line by line. In the first line of second stanza, on sour cream walls, that walls are not painted properly. The color of the walls are sour, means unpleasant. And here, on sour cream walls, means if such type of walls are there, means nowadays in everywhere, so many people now, they are taking care of the color combination. Why? Because it changes the mind of any person. Once you enter in the room, then color also, it is important. Means when our eyes observes that area or the wall, then that mind is getting that energy or peace from that color, and we feel energetic. We feel fresh to work in that area. But here in slum area, that classroom may be painted so many years, and now the color of that walls are not good, and here that is sour cream walls, donations. And one more important word here author used, that is donations. In that donations, Shakespeare's head. So Shakespeare's head, Shakespeare is very great personality, and everybody knows that so many plays, poems, so many things Shakespeare had written, and especially Hamlet, in that to be or not to be, that is question. So many things are famous, and this Shakespeare is here purposefully highlighted and symbolizing the intelligence, representative of the cultural, classical, so many things. So here, but one more thing afterwards I will give you, that all that donations here, Shakespeare's head, it is one of the thing which is donated in that classroom. Then cloudless at dawn, again one of the picture of the cloudless at dawn. If clouds are there, then darkness we can observe, but cloudless image at the dawn, means suppose you can observe the moonlight, stars, because cloudless situation, and that picture, it soothes our eyes. So that also one of the image, it is there. So, and it may be donated by someone. Civilized dome writing also it is. So civilized dome means in that the facilities in the world. So many things are there in this civilized world. Maybe we can observe the universities, then airports, or so many beaches or nearby area where all hotels, means big malls, everything, means in this civilized world, modern world, all the facilities are there, and that civilized world, progressive world, modern world, it is also reflected in one of the image. And one more, belt flowery Tyrolis Valley, and in that Tyrolis Valley, here it is also reflecting the beauty, flowers, the fragrance of the flowers, and it is stark contrast with the fragrance in that slum area. So beautiful flowers, then greenery, nature. So that natural beauty, all that things which are in that classroom, that all the pictures which are hung on that walls, but the color of the wall is so unpleasant color for the eyes, and that children, they will not be happy in that environment. So all that things, and one more, that is open-handed map. So on that wall, one open-handed map is also there, and in that open-handed map, all the things which are exist on this planet or the world, it is also mentioned. Maybe railway lines, airlines, then different facilities in all the cities, or some major cities, pilgrimage, whatever churches, so many things which everybody likes whenever we are surfing on the internet for the tourist spot. We are getting so many spots. So like that, so many things are mentioned in that open-handed map. A word in the world, it's world. And in that, the whole things, all that things, whichever it is, exist in this world. Most of the things which are good, that all the good things are mentioned there, to know that how is the world, how the world is progressed, civilized world. So many things are mentioned in that map. Now here there is a twist. That twist is the contrast. And what is that contrast? And it, for these children, these windows, not this map, their world. So here, poet is trying to highlight that the open-handed map, the image of the open-handed map, which is there on the wall, that map is not the map of the slum area, because in that map, slum area is not mentioned. So here, for these children, these windows, means whatever they are observing through the windows, that is their world. And what they are observing through the windows of that classroom, slum area classroom, then they are observing the slum area from that window. So that slum area is their world. So the world which is shown, which is reflected in the open-handed map, is not the real world for them. Their real world is slum area. So these windows, whatever they are observing through the windows, that is their world. Where all their futures painted with fog. So painted with the fog means the fog is the blur situation. And painted with fog means there is uncertainty about their lives. There is no any opportunity which poet is observing. So there is no vision. There is no clear vision. The vision is blur. There is no vision. There is no opportunity. And there is no hope that there will be progress, because education is very important thing and they are not getting that proper education. So in classroom, infrastructure is also required. Blackboard, proper blackboard in some areas if you will go, whatever the teachers are writing on that blackboard, it will not be visible to the student. So blackboard, all means nowadays internet facility, e-learning, so many things are there, but the slum area children, they are not getting that facilities, and how they will update their knowledge? And in slum area, very few they are interested to go there and teach them. So this is also one of the reality. So here, whatever the poet used, the image of Shakespeare's head, means suppose Shakespeare is great in literature, cultural, all that aspects are there, the intelligence, knowledge, but what will be the use of that knowledge if they are not getting basic education? So how they will test the beauty of the literature, understanding of the society in that literature, how they will test the humor, climax, so many things. It is there, it is hidden in the literature of Shakespeare, but how they will enjoy that? So what there will not be, it means the image of the Shakespeare will not be ideal for the children, because they are not getting proper education. One more thing, that is cloudless at dawn. Cloudless at dawn means they can observe the moonlights, then they can observe the stars. So condition, but it is the stark contrast condition in that slum area, because that area, it is like a clumsy area. So many people, they are living in very less space. And because of that, in that classroom, too much darkness is there, and electricity facility may not be there. So how they will enjoy? So this also picture, it is also not useful for them. And one more thing, that is civilized dome riding all cities, or whatever the things which are exist in this world, progressive things are there in this world. There are so many universities in this world. River, caves, so many things are there. But the children in the slum area, they don't know how is the world outside that slum area. And the map, open-handed map, in that map, so many things which are exist in this world, and everybody should know that. Suppose in India, Taj Mahal, very important thing for everyone. Everybody likes to see that. Or there are so many different places where everybody wish to visit, but that places are mentioned in that open-handed map. But all the things are not good for the slum area, because their world means the slum area, it is not mentioned in that open-handed map. So how the people in the world, they will understand that there is a slum area in that country? How they will reach that place because that place is not mentioned in the map. So how people will go there and they will observe the condition of slum area because it is not mentioned in the map. So even though the wordings are avowed in the words it word, but that condition, it is not favorable for the slum area. Then poet further is trying to say that where all their futures painted with the fog, that their future is, there is no certainty about their future. And why there is no certainty? The narrow street sealed in with the lead sky, means the lead sky where all that opportunities are there, but their condition, it is like a narrow street and that is also sealed in, means there is a restriction to them. The condition is like that they will not come out from that situation and they will explore the world. And what is there in the world? It is here mentioned, but they are far, far from rivers, caves and stars of words. So three things are important, that is rivers. So everybody can understand that nearby river, so many villages, towns situated, because water is important for everyone. To set up industries, for human being, that water is important, but they are far, far from rivers, means that civilization, standard way of living the life, they are far, far from rivers. Caves means the adventure, the beauty of that caves or in that ocean. Suppose you wish to go in the ocean or to explore the things or to connect the world through ocean, but that thing, it is also far, far away from their imagination. And stars of words. So the stars of words here reflected as here education. So they are far, far away from the quality education. They are not getting that quality education in that slum area. Title, it is given, an elementary school classroom in a slum. And in that slum area, they are not getting that quality education. Sometimes teachers may not accept that recruitment. They may not go there. That is also one of the possibility. So here we can understand that if they are not getting the quality education, if they have the problem of health, if they are reciting that father's now disease, if they are unhealthy and they're all that things which are exist in that slum area, which are creating the chaos in their life, so how they will go ahead? So there is a big question mark. Then in further stanza, again poet used some images, symbols, metaphors, simile to highlight that same situation. So here, far, far from rivers, far, far repetition, far from alliteration. So poet used so many poetic devices to highlight the condition of slum area children. Okay, we will think about next stanza. Surely Shakespeare is wicked. Surely Shakespeare is wicked. The map a bad example, with ships and sun and love tempting them to steal. For lives that slyly turn to their crank holes, from fog to endless night, on their slang heap, these children wear skins peeped through by bones and spectacles of steel with mended glass, like bottle bits on stones. All of their time and space are foggy slum. So blot their maps with slum as big as doom. So here in the first line, surely the word is used surely. Shakespeare is wicked. Shakespeare is not good example for slum area children. We already discussed that Shakespeare's literature or the greatness of the Shakespeare, it is not good for the slum area children because they are not getting basic education. So how they will enjoy the beauty of the literature? One more important thing we can understand here in that the map, a bad example, the open-handed map which is mentioned, which is there in that slum area, that open-handed map is also not good example. That is the map, a bad example, because slum area is not mentioned. So if slum area is not mentioned, what will happen? That slum area people, they will not get that help which is required to them from outside world, because no one will understand that slum area it is exist in that country. One more thing here, with ships and sun and love tempting them to steal. So here three important words: ships, sun and love. So ships here, it is important that when we are going for a voyage, the beauty of the world, beauty of the nature and that adventure, so many things we can enjoy, and that enjoyment it is lacking in the slum area children. One more: sun, the beauty of the sun, the sunlight of the sun, brightness of the sun, energy of the sun, optimism, whatever it is there due to sun, that everything it is lacking. And one more, that is love, and the love of the society, love of the people. And because here poet is highlighting the two important themes, that is social injustice and class inequalities. So slum area children, they are not getting that love from the society. The people, those who are living outside that slum area, they will not send their children to play with the slum area children, because they will think about the personal hygiene, they will think about the social hygiene. So day by day there will be that gap. The poor will become poor, the rich will become rich. That's, they will not have that equality. So here, with ships and sun and love tempting them to steal. So there is the thing in their mind that still, the word still is used. They are also willing to get that things, but tempting means here not with the proper way. If they are not getting that things, so they will think to steal that with immoral way. So here poet is trying to highlight the condition that everybody requires the love of the society. Nobody is thinking about the slum area. So the condition is as it is so many years. For life that slyly turned to their cramped pools. And for lives, their condition, it is slyly turned their cramped pools. So slyly, secretly their lives are slowly changing into the cramped pools. And the cramped pools, their darkness is there. So here poet is indirectly highlighting using the word cramped pools. That is very narrow, that cramped pools. And when you will look into that cramped pools, the total darkness means how they will come out from that slum area condition, and they will explore the world and they will get that equal opportunities which others are getting, and how they will compete with the world, it is not possible because their lives will slowly, it will turn into the darkness. harness or the cracked poles, because their health will deteriorate day by day, they will not get proper education, and they will be involved in the slum area children. So that is very important thing here poet is highlighting. And one more, now from fog to endless night. At least the fog situation, it is blur. We can at least observe little things. It is blur, but that blur condition will change into endless night, and that night will be endless, means the total darkness. Means that cramped holes, things, it will change into the total darkness. There will not be any vision in their life that they will come out from the situation. On their slang heap, these children were skin stiff through by bones. So slang heaps, that is unwanted part, the vestige. So here it is indirectly poet is highlighting that the slum area children, it is like the heaps of the garbage or so many waste material. Their also condition it is like this, because their condition is malnutritious. They are not getting proper food or nutrition. So their condition it is, they are, means in first stanza it is mentioned that paper seeming boy. The boy is very thin like a paper and become too much white like a paper, because when there is no enough blood in the body, the skin will look white. So many things here poet is trying to highlight, that from fog to endless night, on their slang heap, the children were skin stiff through by bones. So they are looking like a skeletons, and they are wearing the skins. Means when they are sitting in that classroom, we can observe that their condition, it is like they are like a skeletons and they are wearing the skins like clothes. How we are wearing the clothes? Like that they are wearing the skin. Means you can understand to this that how there is a, they are in poverty stricken, because in slum area, you can observe that their parents are addicted towards the drugs or alcohol. So many means things are there. They are not getting that means love from the society, opportunity in the outside world. So how they will create the good atmosphere in the children? Children are also facing the same problem, that they are also not getting the good environment. So generation by generation, situation will be as it is. And spectacles of steel with mended glass. So spectacles, through spectacles, why we have used the specs? The reason is that if the vision is not clear, through spectacles we can see the things clearly, but that spectacles are also mended. So mended glass will not have the clear vision. So this is also properly mentioned, like bottle bits on stones. That mended glass will look like a bottle bits on. Here poet used the simile, poetic device, like all of their time and space are foggy slum. So here their time and space, it is foggy slum, and it is blur, uncertainty about their future. There is no any kind of hope. Now here poet is observing in that situation, or the faces, poet is observing the faces, observing that children. So there is uncertainty. All of their time and space are foggy slum. So now poet is aggressive. So blot their maps with slums as big as doom. So poet is here aggressive, and poet is saying, so blot blot their maps, the open-handed map. In that spot, the slum area, as like a doom, that is big destruction, and let the everyone come to know that the slum area it is exist in the world and they need help. They need that love from the society. They need the equality from the society. They need equal opportunities to explore the world. Because God has given talent to everyone, even though that person is living in the slum area or any area. So, let them also have that thing which is required for everyone. So, poet is aggressive and poet is saying, so blot their maps with slums as big as doom, as like a destruction. And everybody should notice that slum areas are there on this planet or on this world. So, this is very important thing. Then that map will not be the bad example. But now, the open-handed map is the bad example. Then, last stanza, stanza number 4, unless governor, inspector, visitor, this map becomes their window, and these windows that shut upon their life like catacombs, break, oh break, open till they break the town, and show the children to green fields and make their world run azure on gold sands. And let their tongues run naked into books. The white and green leaves open. History bears whose language is the sun. So here, poet is hopeful. And poet is thinking that unless the governor, inspector, visitor, poet is thinking about those who are in the ruling party, playing the main role like a governor or inspector, local area inspector, or the visitors, tourists, or NGOs, they should take initiative to change the world of the slum area children. So, unless governor, inspector, visitor, this map becomes their window and these windows that shut upon their lives like catacombs. So here, their lives are like catacombs, underground graves. So, when their lives will change, when those who are in the ruling party, they will visit that place and they will provide fund or they will raise the fund for slum area, and then that slum area will change. That slum area schools, atmosphere will change. They will get nice atmosphere, they will get ground, all facilities for playing, and they will get good teachers also to teach. Then that basic important thing which is required for the slum area children, with the infrastructure which is required for schools, that all things will be provided, or it will be donated, money will be donated to that area, and then there will be change. So, poet is optimistic here, and this map becomes their window. Earlier in the second stanza, poet is mentioning that for these children, these windows, not this map, their world. These windows are their world. But in the fourth stanza, this map becomes their window. This map becomes their window means here the whole world. Now they will get that opportunity to explore the whole world, and the whole world is now there. Let them go anywhere in the world and compete with the world. So that is very important. One more thing here. And these windows that shut upon their lives like catacombs. These windows means the slum area. That slum area, it is very dangerous for them. And why it is dangerous? Because like catacombs, like underground graves, they are living in such a condition where they are not noticed by others, and others, they are not understanding what is the condition of slum area children. So here poet is becoming again aggressive. Break, oh break, open till they break the town. And oh break, break, open till they break the town. And let us break that situation and let them help and show the children the green fields. Means, let them enjoy the nature. Let them come out from that slum area and let them see the beauty of the nature. Let them enjoy all that facilities which are exist in this world. Show the children green fields and make their world run a jewel on gold sands. So everybody likes, right, to run on the gold sands or the sky which is blue and without clouds, where everyone can like that such type of atmosphere. So here, make their world run azure on gold sands. Let them also enjoy their world. That enjoyment is very important in childhood age also. So let them also enjoy their life. So why we are wasting their childhood, and that is very important for the everyone. Let them also enjoy the childhood age as like other children. And let their tongues run naked into books. This is very important, that let them also test the education, the test of the education. Let them also learn so many things, encyclopedia, so many things which are exist, or the knowledge which is exist in the books. Let them also go through all that things. So what will happen? If they will get that knowledge, then only they can compete the other children, or there will be healthy competition. Without strengthening their abilities, it will not be possible for them to compete. So here poet is mentioning that let their tongues run naked into books. So let them give that opportunities and let them fulfill the dreams, whatever dreams the children in the slum area have. They will fulfill that dreams. They will get that opportunities, and they will show the world that they have that strength. But give them that opportunities. Books, the white and green leaves open. So here two words, white and green leaves. Metaphor here, poet used the metaphor. Let their tongues run naked into books, the white. So here, concerned with the book, that is white and green leaves. Means the beauty of the nature. We are learning so many things from the nature. So it is important that everyone should get that opportunity to enjoy the beauty of the nature and learn so many things. So let them also get that same opportunity. Open means green leaves open. History theirs was language is the sun. So last line is very important. History theirs was language is the sun. So sun is the symbol of brightness. Sun is the symbol of energy. Sun is the symbol of strength. So all that things means history theirs was language is the sun. So if the darkness from their life, it is now their condition is like a catacombs, like underground graves. Their condition is like a cramp holes. They are living in that cramp holes. The other creatures, they are living in that cramp holes, which are unnoticed by the world. So let them come out from that area and let them enjoy. So they will not think to tempting them to steal, because they are getting the three things, that is sleep, sun and love. So this understanding is very important. So history theirs was language is the sun, and they will also create history. How they will create history? When they will get the equal opportunity, when there is no space for the social injustice, when there is no space for the class inequalities, when everyone will go there and when everyone will support them, obviously what will happen? They will get the proper opportunities, and that proper opportunities will change their lives, and they will also contribute to the world. They will also do the research, and they will also become the scientists. They will also become the good players, means sportsmen. They will also become the, means one of the important person or politician. So many different things they will do, and that contribution will be recognized, and it will become the history. And then here we can understand the history theirs, whose language is the sun. Without that brightness, without the energy, without the help of the good things, it is not possible. So the meaning of the poem, through poetic devices, use of different words. So when you are reading the poem, go into that condition. Visualize the scene, that how they are living, and it is very important to give them help. So helping hand. So whenever you will have that opportunity to visit such type of places, so it's my appeal on this platform that CBSE has given this poem to learn. So here indirectly, that syllabus designers, they are thinking that you will try, you will go there, and you will avoid blaming them, you will avoid criticizing them, but you will feel that they are also the part of the world, and it is our duty as a citizen to help them. Thank you.